how quick and easy it is to brew your own kombucha at home. Now, kombucha, if you're not familiar, is fermented sweet tea. Right here I have my kombucha in a glass vessel with a spigot. This is a continuous brew system. So we're going to first start by making the sweet tea that feeds the kombucha. So I have a quarter cup of sugar in a quart-sized jar I'm going to add hot water to. So I'm dissolving the sugar first. I filled the jar about two-thirds of the way full. And now I'm going to add the tea. I use tea bags. You could use loose tea if you prefer. We'll let that sit for a couple minutes, and while that's brewing, I'm going to show you how we can flavor the kombucha. So kombucha, you can just drink plain, straight out of the spigot. It's good for digestion. It does have a little bit of a vinegary taste to it, kind of sour, kind of earthy. So a lot of people like to add more flavor to it with a second ferment. So one way to do that is to add fruit juice to it. I have a jar, a bottle that I kept from a commercial brand of kombucha that I bought, so these are good to recycle. So we can just fill the rest of it up with kombucha all the way to the top and cap it and let it sit for a couple days. Or if you really want to try to get some carbonation with it, you can get these flip-top bottles, which make a real tight seal, and that'll keep the carbonation in while it's doing its second fermentation. So one of my favorite flavors to do is lemon ginger. So over here on the cutting board, I have, it's a little less than a teaspoon of chopped up fresh ginger, and then I have a quarter of a lemon. So just put those directly in the bottle. So kind of a rule of thumb to start with when you're experimenting with different flavors is about 1 ounce of fruit juice, or you could use fresh or frozen fruit, or if you want to use dried herbs or spices, about a teaspoon per bottle. These bottles are 16 ounces. So again, we'll just fill it straight from the spigot. Want to leave some room at the top for pressure to build. So if you let these sit out without burping them, you could risk bottles exploding. So I just leave it out for anywhere from 1 to 3 days. Again, that kind of depends on the weather, how hot it is out. It's going to ferment faster when the weather's hotter, if your house is hotter, than in the winter when it's cooler out. So let's just take another minute to talk about this. You can do kombucha one batch at a time. You need a SCOBY, which stands for Symbiotic Colony of Bacteria and Yeast. But you could also do a continuous brew, which I think is a lot easier, because you take the kombucha out, and then you just brew the sweet tea and pour it back in. I have this jar that I already brewed and cooled it down to room temperature, so all I'm going to do is take the cover off, pour it in, the SCOBY in here is starting to make babies, so pretty soon I'm going to start separating it and create a SCOBY hotel, so I have backups in case any mold starts to grow on this. That's what this cover is for. It's to keep fruit flies out and also mold. It's just a tight loop cloth, an old dish towel that I keep on with a rubber band. So it's been a couple minutes. We'll take the tea bags out of here. And what I do is I just add ice the rest of the way into the jar to speed up it cooling down. Temperature before you add it to your SCOBY, so that's about 68 to 85 degrees Fahrenheit. I use an instant read thermometer to check that. So I hope you like this video. You can see how quick and easy it can be to make kombucha at home. It's also a lot more affordable than buying the commercial brands. And you can experiment with all sorts of flavors. I'll include some recipes in the blog, so be sure to check that out in the description. Subscribe to my channel and check out my blog at carolynlovesnutrition.com. Follow me on Instagram and Facebook at Carolyn Loves Nutrition. Thank you.